Hello everyone, my name is Guruprasad Kehan, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, ATME College of Engineering, Mysore. In this video, today I am demonstrating how to verify Thevenin's theorem both theoretically and practically. To start with, first let me explain what is Thevenin's theorem. The statement goes like this: a linear network consisting of a number of voltage sources and resistances can be replaced by an equivalent network having a single voltage source called Thevenin's voltage and a single resistance called Thevenin's resistance. So using this theorem, now we will prove how it works. So look at the circuit diagram. Here we have a power supply V1 equal to 10 volts. R1, R2, R3, three resistors of same value 330 ohms and a load resistance of 1 kilo ohms, and we require 1 milliammeter to calculate load current. Now I'll show you how to connect this circuit. So I have a breadboard with me and I have three 330 ohm resistors and I have a power supply and 1 milliammeter, and I also require 1 multimeter. So first let me connect a 330 ohm resistor. I have connected 330 ohm resistor, and along with that one I am also connecting another 330 ohm resistor, that is R2. Now we will take R3. R1, R2, R3, they share a one junction, and another end of R3 I am directly connecting it to the ground terminal. Now between this end of R1 and another end of R3 I am connecting power supply. So positive terminal of the power supply is connected to one end of R1, and the negative terminal of power supply is connected to ground. Now as per the circuit diagram, I will take milliammeter now. So positive terminal of milliammeter is connected to one terminal of R2, and another terminal of milliammeter is connected to some other point where I will be connecting 1 kilo ohm resistor. Now I will take 1 kilo ohm resistor. One end of 1 kilo ohm resistor is connected to milliammeter. Another end I am directly connecting to the common point, that is ground. Now the circuit is completed. I have connected V1, that is from power supply. So this one is R1, R2, R3. These two wires are from milliammeter, and this one is RL, load resistance. Now I'll switch on the power supply. I'll set it 10 volts. It's already set to 10 volts. Now I'll switch on milliammeter. So now milliammeter is showing the readings 3.3 milliamperes. Now I will note down that value, IL equal to 3.3 milliamperes. So the practical value we have got 3.3 milliamperes. Now let us see whether this value is right or wrong using theoretical calculations. So now here I am taking two loops. This is loop 1 and this one is loop 2. The current in loop 1 is denoted as I1. The current in loop 2 is denoted as I2. So coming to the loop 1, when I apply KVL, 10 equal to 330 plus 330 into I1, that is 660 I1 minus 330 I2. So 10 equal to 660 I1 minus 330 I2. In the second loop, since there are no power supplies, I will take it as 0, and I will add all the resistors, 330 plus 330 plus 1000, that is 1 kilo ohm, 1000 टोटल 1660 ओम्स. सो 0 इक्वल टू 1660 I2 सिंस द करंट इन लूप 2 आई हैव टेकन इट एज I2 माइनस 330 I1. सो आई हैव टू सब्सट्रैक्ट द करंट फ्रॉम लूप 1 दैट इज 330 I1. I will rearrange these equations in the standard format. Now I will substitute these two equations and I will get the answer I1 equal to 16.8 milliamperes and I2 equal to 3.34 milliamperes. So this I2 in loop 2 is nothing but load current IL. So load current IL will be equal to 3.34 milliamperes. Now the second step in Thevenin's theorem is to find out Thevenin's equivalent voltage, that is VTH. So to find out VTH, the procedure we are supposed to follow is to open circuit the outer terminal. So I have to remove all the components which are at this terminal. So I have removed milliammeter and I have also removed 1 kilo ohm resistance. So after open circuiting this one, I will calculate what is the value of voltage, that is nothing but VTH, Thevenin's equivalent voltage, which is also denoted as VOC, that is open circuit voltage. Now move to the circuit. Now I will remove this milliammeter I am keeping aside. I am also removing 1 kilo ohm resistance and I will take multimeter. I will set it to voltage and I will calculate what is Thevenin's equivalent voltage. Now we can see we are getting 5 volts, approximately 5 volts. So Thevenin's equivalent voltage is approximately 5 volts. Now let us see whether this answer is correct or right using theoretical calculations. So to find out VTH, I am using the formula R3 into I. R3 is this resistance, I is the current in loop 1. So we don't know the answer for I. So I will be equal to V by R. So here the R in loop 1 is R1 plus R3. So V divided by R1 plus R3. So V equal to 10 volts, R1 plus R3, 330 plus 330. 660 ohms. So the answer what I have got is 15 milliamperes. Now this 15 milliamperes is multiplied with 330 ohms. So the theoretical value of VTH is 4.95. So practically I have got 5 volts, theoretically 4.95 volts. Now the next step in Thevenin's theorem is to find out RTH, that is Thevenin's equivalent resistance. The procedure we are supposed to follow to calculate RTH is I have to turn off the independent sources. So I am removing the voltage source V, what we have connected here, that I will be showing now in the diagram. So here I have connected V1. So I am removing this one and I am switching it off. Then the points where I had connected V1, I am short circuiting it. I am connecting another wire. Now I will set it to resistance 2 kilo. Now if I observe, the answer what I am getting is 0.49 kilo or 490 ohms. That I will note down here, 490 ohms. Now let us prove whether this answer is right or wrong theoretically. So to do theoretical calculation, RTH is equal to R1 parallel with R3 plus R2. So I am using this formula, R1 parallel with R3, since R1 and R3 are parallel, in addition to R2. So 330 parallel with 330 plus 330, the answer I have got is 495 ohms, whereas practically I have got 490 ohms. Now let us go for Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So in this circuit, we are supposed to replace voltage source by its equivalent value, that is 5 volts, and RTH. So the nearest value which is available in the lab, I am taking it as 470 instead of 490 ohms, or else we can also use a decayed resistance box. And I am using a milliammeter and followed by RL 1 kilo ohm. Now I will show you the connections. So I will take 470 ohms. I have connected this one 470 ohm. Power supply, one end of power supply is connected to one end of 470 ohm, and another end is directly I will connect it to ground. Then one end of milliammeter connected to 470 ohm, another end of milliammeter I am connecting to some other point, and here I am using 1 kilo ohm resistance to close the loop. I repeat, this circuit is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. These two are from power supply. So power supply, now we are supposed to set it to 5 volts. We have to set it to Thevenin's equivalent voltage, and the resistance we are supposed to set it to Thevenin's equivalent resistance, RTH. Now I am using it as 470 ohms, the nearest value what is available, and this one is 1 kilo ohm and this one is milliammeter. Now if I check the value in milliammeter, the answer what I am getting is 3.3 to 3.4 milliamperes. I will note down that value, 3.3 milliamperes. Now let us check whether this answer is theoretically correct or not. So IL, that is load current, so can be calculated as VTH divided by RTH plus RL. VTH 5 volts, RTH 495 theoretically, and RL 1 kilo ohm, and IL I have got 3.34 milliamperes. So which is equal to what we have done earlier, that is 3.34 milliamperes. So this one we have got theoretically, and this one theoretically for the last circuit, and this is practically for equivalent circuit, and this is practically for actual circuit. So this is how we can prove Thevenin's theorem both theoretically and practically. Thank you from ATME College of Engineering.